There is across the land a financial repression on a nominal basis, on an inflation-adjusted basis. It's not pretty out there. What is the best Calamos strategy right now to find total return, to grab the coupon, and maybe make a little bit more? How do you do that?
Well, there's no question, you know, we're in uncharted waters where there's volatility in the markets. And our strategies, which we've been using for over 41 years, have been ones that manage risk very well. And that's something that people need to do in these markets. It's being able to capture as much of the upside as you can, but protect yourself on the downside. And for us at Calamos Investments, our portfolio managers and co-CIOs have done a really good job in performing, predominantly more recently, in liquid alts. If you look
Excuse me, what is a liquid alt? Wait, I had a liquid alt last night. Yeah. Other than that, what's a liquid alt?
I'm not sure it's the same liquid alt that you're describing.
Maybe it should be.
But maybe it is. And, you know, during these markets, it's sometimes you have to look at those. But liquid alts are derivatives in terms of some, I'll give you an example of some of our funds, market neutral. We have a long short fund. We have an hedged equity fund, not just straight long type of, of funds. That's what liquid alts are. And that they have, in case of Calamos, we've been pioneers in convertible bonds.
Right.
And that protects you in terms of the downside and gives you most of the upside. If you look at the markets.
All right, John, is there anything that the financial markets don't understand? Right. What caught my eye when a lot of these big Wall Street guys were testifying yesterday is that a lot of the people asking the questions brought it back to the financial crisis. Well, frankly, a lot of the chief executives just didn't know what they had in their books. Do we know that actually for a fact they know what's in their books today?
Well, I think they're much better off today than they were 10, 12 years ago, there's no question. And my previous job, I did one, Mizuho in Americas, which was one of the biggest global banks. And like Jamie Dimon, he tries to make sure, even though he did have some things happen in the UK, do things that you completely understand. And if you can't understand them, if people don't come into your office and can't explain it in 10 minutes, don't do it. And that's kind of been a rule of thumb. And I think that because of the crisis, a lot more people are doing that. Now, having said that, markets, people tend to forget. And the quest for yield in this market, especially when rates are inverted, you have negative rates in certain countries around the world, continues to put pressure on Wall Street to come up with different tools that they can capture yield. And that's why I still think that we have some positive upside in our U.S. equity markets as well.